What's up guys, welcome to our channel. If you're new here, I'm Zoe, I'm a foundation dentist working here in London.
And I'm Ali, a final year dental student studying at Newcastle.
This video you're about to watch is a much shorter clip of the longer video we did on diagnosis. We just thought we'd put a shorter clip out there just in case anyone wanted to focus on this little topic. If you want to watch the full video, I'll put a link in the description.
The next thing we're going to be discussing is tooth surface loss. Tooth surface loss is the loss of hard tissue caused by factors other than caries. The four types we're going to be discussing are erosion, attrition, abrasion, and abfraction.
The first one is erosion, which is tooth surface loss caused by a chemical process like an acid attack not involving bacteria. And there are both intrinsic and extrinsic sources of acid. Intrinsic sources are things like acid reflux or vomiting. And these patients usually present with palatal tooth surface loss on the upper teeth. With these patients, you don't see much tooth surface loss on the lower molars or the incisors because as they have acid reflux or they throw up, their tongue goes over and protects those teeth. Now, extrinsic sources are mainly diet related, like fizzy drinks and juices. These patients mostly present with tooth surface loss on the labial surfaces of incisors and the occlusal surfaces of molars. In both types, you might see bowl-like wear facets, sometimes called a ring of enamel. And this happens because the dentine wears away at a faster rate than the enamel. There's also environmental sources of acid, like working in environments such as a battery factory. This is a lot rarer now because of stricter health and safety regulations. There are plenty of other causes for tooth surface loss as well, so pause here for the full list that we've come up with. Once you've identified the cause, there's a couple things to look out for when assessing patients as to whether the tooth surface loss is ongoing or arrested. If there's staining on the teeth, this suggests that it's been arrested because if it was active, the stain layer would have worn out. A sign of inactive tooth surface loss is when they used to experience hypersensitivity, but now they don't. And when you look into their mouth, you can see signs of tooth surface loss like the ones that we talked about before. The sensitivity here has stopped because the cause of tooth surface loss has stopped as well and has allowed time for tertiary dentine to form.
The next type of tooth surface loss is attrition, which is tooth wear caused by tooth-to-tooth contact, usually associated with grinding and parafunctional activities. Patients usually present with smooth facets, which are flat and match the opposing teeth, and you usually see it happening at the same time as erosion. That's because erosion will demineralize the hard tissues, which weakens it, and then grinding wears it away. If the tooth surface loss by attrition is extensive and rapid, you should expect to see a reduction in the OVD, so the patient would look overclosed, or like a grandma with no teeth. You wouldn't see this if the tooth wear was gradual, because dentoalveolar compensation will maintain their OVD. Dentoalveolar compensation is the process where alveolar bone remodels and elongates to compensate for the loss of vertical dimension. For example, you can see the difference in these photos. You've got no dental alveolar compensation on the left, and the gingival margins of all the lower incisors are in one straight line. In the photo on the right, you can see the lower incisors are at a higher level compared to the canines due to the dentoalveolar compensation. You can also see an increased width of the attached gingiva.
Next type of tooth surface loss is abrasion, and it's tooth wear caused by tooth to non-tooth contact. So for example, hard tooth brushing with charcoal activated toothpaste, or habits like pen biting. Depending on the habit, the patient will often present differently. So for example, if a patient is right-handed and constantly over brushing the left side of their mouth, you would see that the tooth wear on the buccal cervical margins of the upper left teeth, whereas with pen biting, you will see chipped incisal edges.
The last type of tooth surface loss is known as abfraction. This is defined as a fracture on the cervical margin, which is caused by flexures upon occlusal loading. This is how it looks. Abfraction is sometimes missed out from books which talk about tooth surface loss because it's not believed to be as relevant or necessarily true.
Okay guys, so that was it for this clip. Thank you guys for watching. If you want to see the full video on diagnosis, I'll put it in the suggestions here, or you can check out the other videos that we have on the channel.